six-time world champion Lewis Hamilton is now the highest paid sportsman in Formula One history. The British driver has banked an amazing $489 million in career earnings, topping that of former all-time earner and seven-time champion Michael Schumacher. Lewis made over $57 million for Mercedes in 2019 alone, including salaries and bonuses. Away from the track, Lewis is famous for his colorful clothing and celebrity friends, everyone from Kate Hudson to the Kardashians to the Biebs himself. In 2015, Mercedes F1 boss Toto Wolff said that Lewis is probably the only superstar in Formula One, and if you've ever taken a look at his Instagram page, then you know he sure lives like it. And he's also got the homes to prove it. Lewis Hamilton is an F1 race car driver who's accumulated both wealth and all kinds of trophies since joining Mercedes in 2013 after jumping ship from McLaren. In the space of 7 years, he's won 6 world championships and amassed 63 of his 84 career wins. This sporting hero dreamt of being a race car icon from the tender age of just 4 years old when his dad, Anthony Hamilton, first bought him a remote control car. Lewis would use the car to compete in championship races as a child, and he once finished second in the National BRCA Championship. After that, Lewis's father bought him a go-kart for Christmas when he was 6, developing his son's passion and talent for driving that would turn him into such a success story later on in his life. Lewis has said about that time in his life, "To be honest, it started out as a hobby, something for my dad and I to do together. At one point, my dad had 4 jobs just to keep us karting. He gave up everything for me. I wouldn't be a champion if it wasn't for my dad." His father's sacrifice ensured that his son would one day be able to afford the nicest of homes to live in, including penthouses in New York City, a Victorian mansion in London, a secret getaway in Geneva, a tax haven in Monaco, and a love nest in Granada. Hi guys, it's Kara, and today we're taking a look at the lineage of homes that superstar F1 driver Lewis Hamilton lives in, here for you on Famous Entertainment. With Lewis's most recent victory at the Grand Prix in Spielberg, Austria, and his activism in support of the Black Lives Matter movement, Lewis is in the news more than ever, and you guys have been asking me to take an inside look at where he lives. Well, today I'm gonna do just that. Don't forget to like, hit subscribe, and ring that bell to be notified when we post so you never miss a vid. We've also done house tours in the likes of Floyd Mayweather and Steph Curry, and we'll link to some at the end. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and as usual, let me know whose house tour is next in those comments down below. Now let's get into this video. Last year, Lewis reportedly dropped a cool $40 million on this penthouse in Manhattan. This condo project is part owned by NFL great Tom Brady and his supermodel wife Gisele Bündchen. Lewis's neighbors reportedly include the likes of Jennifer Lawrence and Austin Powers himself, Mike Myers. This 6,547 square foot home includes a huge outdoor space with multiple setback terraces, offering Lewis a spacious setting from which to enjoy the dramatic city, river, and sunset views over top the Hudson River. It also features a swimming pool, fitness center, squash court, library, and wine cellar. The kitchen is of course top of the line, and each room features floor-to-ceiling windows to ensure stunning views 24/7. After purchasing that penthouse, Lewis then listed this apartment he purchased back in 2017 from $43.9 million. This 8,900 square foot unit features 5 bedrooms with 6 bathrooms and is located in the Tribeca neighborhood of New York City. Tribeca has been ranked as the highest priced neighborhood in Manhattan for the past several years, and Lewis put his place on the market for $57 million. If you've got that kind of cash just lying around, then you can snatch this place up and live in the same building as the likes of Meg Ryan, Jake Gyllenhaal, Bella Hadid, The Weeknd, and Justin Timberlake. This building was once a former factory and retained some of its industrial feel with wooden beams and support brackets in a double height living room. It features floating stairs to get between its 3 floors and also features an in-unit private elevator just in case you feel like taking it easy for a night. The living room has an abundant amount of natural light coming through its tall windows, and the subdued kitchen uses Christopher Peacock cabinetry with chef quality appliances and pendant style overhead lighting. The master bedroom has a gas-lit fireplace and is attached to a spa-like bathroom and separate dressing room. Outside is a private terrace featuring a plunge pool and glass-walled room that can be used for entertaining in a warm place, just in case that New York City weather is being a little temperamental. Inside of that room is a gas fireplace, wet bar, and a half bathroom. The monthly maintenance fees for this place are around 16K, which provide for 24-hour doorman, concierge, superintendent, upkeep for the large lobby courtyard, a children's playroom, exercise facilities with a 75-foot pool, and Turkish steam bath spa. Perhaps most amazing of all, after spending all that money on this place, Louis reportedly never actually lived in it before placing it back on the market. One place that Louis most definitely spends more time at is the Victorian mansion he owns in Kensington, West London. This home is a four-story mansion that features six luxurious bedrooms and two gigantic bathrooms. The property also boasts a huge kitchen and special dining area for parties, including four reception rooms to be used for entertaining and casual gatherings that spills out into a 200-foot lush green garden, which also contains an amazing summer house. Louis purchased this home back in 2017 from previous owners Burberry chief designer Christopher Bailey and his husband actor Simon Woods. The property is believed to have been originally built by Samuel Adams in 1860 and is estimated to be worth around $25 million. Alright, these next few I'm going to go through a little more quickly because specific details on them are a little hard to come by. But here's what we know. First of all, Louis owns an apartment in Geneva, Switzerland. This is a secret property that Louis tries to keep on the down low, and he uses it as his Swiss retreat. It's reportedly a three-bedroom apartment in a six-story building located in Louis' village, Nyon. Fernando Alonso, Felipe Massa, and other F1 driver extraordinaire Michael Schumacher are said to be residents in the same abode. It's believed that the apartment boasts some incredible views of Lake Geneva and is the perfect place for Louis to clear his head with all of the natural peace and tranquility of its setting. A whole lot of Formula One drivers have a home in Monaco, and Louis is no different. Not only is Monaco home to one of the most famous races in all Formula One racing, it's also a tax-free city, which means that Louis gets to keep all the millions he earns without the tax collector reaching in to take their cut. So right off the bat, that's a huge bonus for a man banking the type of cash he currently is. His apartment is reportedly located in the exclusive Fonteville district, which has a population of just over 3,000 people. Specific details on this apartment are almost as hard to come by as his Geneva home, but it's believed that Louis dropped around $15 million to get a hold of this property, which considering the aforementioned tax breaks, means this place has probably already paid for itself 100 times over. The apartment is said to be 2,000 square feet and features four bedrooms with multiple bathrooms, a steam room, and a 300 square foot sun terrace for enjoying what must be some absolutely gorgeous views. Finally, we come to one last gigantic real estate purchase that Louis made back in 2008 when he invested $30 million for the land to house a former hotel in Granada. His father is originally from Granada, and Louis purchased this property while in a relationship with Nicole Scherzinger, intending to turn it into a love nest. Louis had an Italian developer tear down the former property and create a personalized home that featured a built-in recording studio, private gym, gourmet kitchen, sunset lounge, and private jetty that boasted the best views in all the Caribbean. However, after Louis split with Nicole, he wanted to offload the property, having never even lived there, much like with his apartment in Tribeca, resulting in a lawsuit between himself and the Italian developer. Alright guys, that brings us to the end of this video. What do you think about all of Louis Hamilton's many homes? Which one would you prefer to live in? Personally, I love Victorian houses, so I might have to go with his place in London, but the Granada vacation spot gives it a run for its money, no doubt. I mean, who wouldn't want an island getaway? Although I love those places, I would pick wherever this little guy spends the most time in. I assume Louis takes Roscoe everywhere with him, and with a dog that precious for company, anywhere would be home enough for me. I can relate. Anyways, be sure to tell me your fave property down in those comments, as well as whose place you'd like to see next in this series. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram if you want to chat, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!